Hello guys, welcome back to the TenorShare channel. If you own an iPad, you'd understand how much we rely on it these days. It just makes everything so much simple, especially when we are working from home. This being said, what would you do when it won't turn itself on? It could stuck on the black screen, an endless boot loop, a spinning wheel, or simply won't charge. No worries, with the tips in this tutorial, you can fix all these by yourself without losing any data. Let's dive in. The first one here is the force restart. Simple, fast, no computer and no data loss. For iPad 7, is press and hold both the top and home button, let go when you see the Apple logo. If this doesn't work, you may want to plug your iPad into power, and let it charge for up to 1 hour. After a few minutes, you should see a charging screen like this. If you don't see the charging screen within an hour, or you see the connect to power screen, you might want to try a different USB cable or power adapter. The original one preferable. This trick is awesome, but it's not some panacea that works every time. So, here is another free method you might want to give a shot. Using the recovery mode feature of ReiBoot. So once open it, plug your device into the computer. Now let's put it into recovery mode. Same as the force restart. But keep holding both buttons till you see the connect to laptop icon. Now go ahead and hit the exit recovery mode button. ReiBoot will get you to the home screen in less than a minute. See, it works. If your iPad stays in the recovery mode, fret not. You have a much more powerful option here, repairing it in standard mode, which fixes tricky issues with no data loss. So once you select the standard repair by default, go ahead and download the firmware. Then here we go. As soon as it says the repair process is completed, you'll see the home screen. The awesome part is all your data are still there. The last one, you might fix this by updating the iOS using iTunes. So once you connect your iPad and put it in recovery mode, go ahead and click update. Download the firmware. Now iTunes will start updating. See, iTunes does the trick too. That's it. Thanks for watching. I hope this video helps you guys. This is TenorShare channel. See you in the next video.